Here we have a two-way table or a contingency table with some data in it. And this data is about good service and poor service during lunch and dinner. Our first question is, if we're selecting one patron at random, what is the probability that their meal was lunch? Well, the way that this table works is we have our totals along the bottom of the table and along the right side of the table. And it looks to me like our total number of patrons that came for lunch was 859. The number of patrons in the restaurant was 2,466. So the probability that a randomly selected patron was there for lunch is 859 divided by 2,466. That turns out to be 0.3483 if we round to four decimal places. Great, next question. What is the probability that they experienced good service given that their meal was dinner? The existence of this word given in this problem suggests that this is a conditional probability. If you want to review conditional probability, there should be a link popping up on your screen right now so that you can watch that lecture. But the notation for this problem is, we want the probability that they got good service given that their meal was dinner. So what we're doing is we're assuming that the meal was dinner. That means we're looking at this row right here and we're ignoring everything else. And we're just asking the question from that row, what is the probability that they got good service? Well, 978 patrons got good service out of 1,607 that were there for dinner. So that is going to be the answer. And if we round to four decimal places, we get 0.6086. We can recall that we had a formula for conditional probability. That looks like this. And in this example, event one is that the patron was there for dinner, and event two is that they got good service. So what this formula says is that our denominator should be the number of patrons who were there for dinner. That number is 1,607 from our table, and our denominator is 1,607, so that checks out. The numerator should be the number of patrons who were there for dinner and got good service. Looking at this chart, that number should be 978. So our numerator should be 978, and that checks out down here. So it looks like we did this problem correctly, whether we use that formula or not. All right, I'll see you in the next problem.